all of you. My name is Daania, Zahra, Faiz, and today I want to share with you a story about courage and perseverance. The title of my story is Oliver Twist, a masterpiece by Charles Dickens. In the 19th century, there lived a young boy in London by the name of Oliver Twist. He had no mother or father, so he lived in an orphanage with other boys. Every day, he was sent to toil in an old factory sewing buttons on shirts. He did not get any money and never got a day off. Oliver was very miserable. He was fed one meal a day, a tiny bowl of porridge called gruel. The gruel tasted horrible. Yuck! It was the only food that he was allowed to eat. One evening, after a heavy day of work, Oliver was very hungry, so he asked for more food from the kitchen master, Mr. Bumble. "Please, sir, I want some more," he said, trembling. "More? We feed you every day and you asked for more?" "Yeah, Mr. Bumble. You ungrateful boy. If you're not happy, you can go and live somewhere else." Mr. Bumble grabbed Oliver by the ear and threw him onto the streets. Oliver was left alone, wandering the dark, filthy alleys, scavenging through bins for scraps of food and sleeping among rats at night. After living alone on the streets for a few days, he met a very scruffy boy. "Hello, Convent. They call me the Artful Dodger," said the boy. "You look hungry. Follow me to my house. There'll be some food there," he said. Oliver was taken to a house full of boys and was introduced to Mr. Fagin. Mr. Fagin was tall and thin and had a sinister smile.
"I will turn this boy into a little rat,"
thought Mr. Fagin to himself. The next day, the Artful Dodger took Oliver out into the streets. "I am going to show you how we play," said he. He slipped up behind a well-dressed man. In a swift action, the Artful Dodger put his hands to the man's pocket and pulled out a stack of money. Running back to Oliver, he shoved the money into Oliver's hands. "Is it stealing?" asked Oliver, horrified by what he saw. The man realized he got robbed, shouted, "That's that boy! He has stolen my money!" pointing towards Oliver. The dodger ran away quickly, leaving Oliver to be caught by a policeman. Fortunately, a witness explained to the policeman that he was innocent and did not steal the man's money. So the policeman let